So, should you give people a second chance? That is the topic of my video today. My name is Priya Kumar. I'm a motivational speaker and an author, and I am here in the Black Forest in Germany making this video for you. Oftentimes people are wary, people complain, and people generally have this emotional turmoil whether they should really give people who have hurt them, who've caused them inconvenience and losses, a second chance. So first of all, we need to decode, how did this problem happen? How did things go so astray and awry that A, you have declared that this person has made a very, very big damage to the point that you're confused now whether you should give the person a second chance or not. And I feel that before you blame somebody else, take a good look at yourself. You know, it's like that old saying, when you point one finger at others, there are four pointing back at you. I would first look at the situation, that how did things go wrong? Sometimes we don't set expectations. We take a lot of things for granted and we assume that ye to pata hi hoga unhe, or this is common sense, or this is how it should be. Well, that is common sense and how it should be for me, but not necessarily you are tuned into the same mindset, the same culture, and the same vision. So sometimes I feel that errors happen, heartbreaks happen, inconveniences happen, losses happen, because expectations were not set from the start. Now, if that is the main problem, then you need to go back to the drawing board and make an agreement. Not necessarily it has to be a formal agreement, but in friendship, make agreements. Look, I'm never going to talk bad about you, and that is something that I don't appreciate. And the last friendship went wrong because the other person was saying this and causing misunderstandings and so on. So it's important to set what you like, what you don't like, in a way setting expectations. Same thing with your colleagues, same thing with your workspace, same thing with your bosses, same thing with your juniors, same thing with people who you hire as help. Please set the expectations right from the start, especially what is a deal breaker. So the person knows very clearly that, look, if these are the things that I do, it's not acceptable, and I might lose this friendship, I might lose this job, or I might lose this deal. So take care from your side and make the extra effort of saving that friendship, of saving that business association, and to avoid any misunderstanding whatsoever. Now, what if the expectations were set and yet there was a violation and a mistake was made, and now the person is asking for forgiveness, or you're doing some soul searching within yourself that should I give this person a second chance or not? Now, if a violation has happened, it could well be that this situation, this work, this friendship, or this relationship is new for the person, and the person is also taking time to adjust. You know, like for instance, I know of this person who started working in a call center recently, and he's working at the night shift. Now, that's not a part of his habit or a part of his daily living, so he is making errors because there is an adjustment that is needed in the tuning of the environment, of the timing, of the culture, and the demands of the job. Now, if errors happen there, I would leave it be. I would give a second chance, because in all fairness, you have to allow the person to tune into the situation. Like if you get married, if you go to a new country, you go to a new job, you have a new friendship, you're making those adjustments and you're also trying. I would give a person a second chance, setting new rules or setting new expectations and giving newer solutions that, look, if this is where the problem is happening, maybe you could try this and you could eliminate the issue. Now, while you offer solutions at a gradient. Sometimes when we tell people, oh, you should never do this again, maybe from where the person is and what you expect, it is a very, very big gap. And a lot of times in trying to reach there, a lot of negativity happens on part of the person who wants to improve. So when you are setting a standard for people, make sure you break it down into chunks. Make sure you ask for a little improvement and adjustment when there are ask for a little improvement and adjustment, and so on. Because also sometimes your expectations from another human being could be totally unrealistic. For instance, if you expect a person to quit on sugar just like that, it's not going to happen. You reduce the sugar, you make it less, you find a substitute and take it to a point one day that the person hates the taste of sugar. So what I'm trying to say is that habits and our own makeup is like that. We need to take improvement also on a gradient scale. Now back to giving a second chance. If you feel that you didn't set the expectations right, go back, make agreements, and also it's important to get an agreement from the other person. Just you saying this is what I want is not enough. The other person must also agree to it. Then if he or she violates, then they well know the consequences that are going to happen. And then you decide whether you really want to give a second chance to a person who gives you his word and then breaks it. This is not just a mistake. This is a violation of a person's promise. Now, if a violation has happened and if you feel that there is room for improvement and the person is genuinely sorry, you put an improvement plan. Not you will never do this. Okay, we will get there. But you watch that. If this is the first gradient that you have offered, okay, the first thing is you sleep on time. This is the guy who is finding it difficult to adjust to the call center scenario. So you sleep on time. Now, if he's not going to sleep on time, which is sleep during the day, then you know he's not going to do a good job in the night. The second is you readjust your clock and timing. Now, if he's not going to do that, you know that everything to follow is going to go kaput. So while you give people a second chance, also follow through on their improvements and keep the feedback going, whether you really feel this is happening or not happening. And I would put a disclaimer saying, look, I'm very happy to give you a second chance, but I'm also watching you. And at any point, if I feel that this is not going in the right direction, please pardon me for letting you go, because it is difficult for me. And you know what? Letting people go, whether they are employees or vendors or friends, is very, very emotionally taxing. I'm an employer myself, and for me to let somebody go, it means, hey, I wasted my time. Now I have to look for somebody else. Now I have to train that person. I'd rather give you a second chance. So if I'm saying that's it, please understand, it's a very, very difficult decision for a person who is letting go. So don't take it to that situation where a person sees no potential, no solution, and no turnaround from you. And hey, if you're on the other line, then you consider all of that. Don't break your word when given an agreement, and improve if that is good for the sake of the project, the friendship, the business, and of course for your future. I hope this helps, and I will be back again with another video. And I am so grateful for your love. Thank you for the connection, and thank you for allowing me the purpose to serve you. So goodbye from Germany. I will see you again.